I think most people have heard about the Arctic and Antarctic region. These are very cold regions surrounded by snow all year round. But what if I tell you, these regions are hiding many more secrets beneath all the snow. Hello friends. I'm Ankita Rao and today I'm going to discuss about Arctic and Antarctic region, also referred to as the North Pole and South Pole. Arctic region is called the North Pole, whereas Antarctic is called the South Pole. These are at the opposite ends at the top and bottom of our planet Earth. These regions are mostly uninhabited. People don't live over there because it's very, very cold. The average temperature is almost minus 30 to minus 40 degrees centigrade, and winters can be even more cold at times. So, the people living there are very, very low. Mostly, the people who go there are researchers who are trying to study that place. Trying to find out the mysteries, uncover the secrets, and the military people to guard that area. Local civilians are generally not allowed there, or at least don't live over there. Those regions are very guarded. Since there is lot of secrecy and lot of people are not allowed to go there, there have been lot of conspiracy theory about this region. Many people feel there are some secrets hidden. That's why the government doesn't want us to know those secrets. And that's why people are not allowed to live over there. I don't know whether it's government or it's just our imagination. But there have been mysteries surrounding it. So I will share some of those mysteries. Pyramids. So in Antarctic region, in the Ellsworth mountain ranges, there are some mountains which are shaped like a pyramid. Some people were searching about that area on Google Earth and they saw some pyramid shaped mountains. They discovered it in 2016, but the US government had discovered this in 1935, and American aviator Lincoln Ellsworth had discovered this mountain region. That's why it's named Ellsworth Mountains. But government didn't tell about it. They didn't think much about it. But people are speculating that just like there are pyramids in Egypt, people say those pyramids were actually built by aliens. There were some alien civilization which had come to Earth and they built this pyramids. Pyramids are kind of like a receptor to communicate with other aliens in other planets, or some pyramids hold some kind of magical powers we don't know about. So there are lots of mysteries and conspiracies about the pyramids of Egypt. So when people discovered that there are pyramid shaped mountains, lots of conspiracy theories began. People started speculating that maybe there were aliens back in the past and they had built this mountainous pyramid structures in the Antarctic region. Or there are aliens still living over there, hidden inside these pyramids. The government doesn't believe it. The scientists are saying that this kind of structure can happen, due to erosion. I don't know how can it can create a perfect shape. Even I am kind of confused, because it's not like there are mountainous region in Antarctica only. There are some regions which have fully covered in ice. There are some in Russia and Siberian in Canada, which are fully covered in ice, but still they don't have a perfect pyramid like shape. Maybe it can be possible, you know, we never know. We don't know the mysteries of Mother Nature. But it's very interesting to see in a perfectly aligned mountains. Nazi. So, many people had speculated that, you know, the Nazis were very much fascinated by the Antarctic region. They were, you know, they had actually set up a base over there. And Russian scientists had recently discovered their base. It was called Treasure Hunter. I cannot pronounce the German name properly, but that base, there were few Nazis living over there, but you know, these people were, you know, poisoned by the bear meat, polar bear meat. They thought they can survive on polar bears, but they couldn't bear it. They got poisoned by it. So for the safety reason, German boat was, you know, called over there, and those people left that area. So that base is empty right now. But many people say that, you know, since Hitler and the Nazis were fascinated by the Antarctic region, they had actually planned to, you know, move over there when they are about to lose the war. When the Nazis realized that they may not win this war, or at least as a backup, they had not formed a base over there. And when they, you know, people say that Adolf Hitler didn't commit suicide, he had actually used a fake person, a dummy person, to as his body, and he and his, you know, other Nazi party, you know, shifted to Antarctica, and they are living in Antarctica region. I sincerely doubt this, but you know, it is rooted in reality. You know, Nazis were actually fascinated by it, and there are photo evidences of their base. I don't think Hitler and his family went over there, but there were definitely Nazis in that region. Flat Earth Antarctica. Mostly people, you know, believe Earth is a globe. It's a three-dimensional globular circle, like a ball. But there are lots of people who believe that Earth is not a globe, but a flat disk. Many people say that Earth is not moving, it's stationary, and all the other planets and stars are moving surrounding the Earth. The Earth doesn't revolve around the Sun, but Sun revolves around Earth. Whereas Earth is a stationary plate, and inside there are all the continents, and it is surrounded by the, you know, Arctic and Antarctic region. In flat Earth theory, Arctic and Antarctic region are not in the North and South Pole, but surrounding the entire planet. They are making sure the water doesn't fall down from Earth, and they are like a barrier. And they believe that US government and other governments of the world are, you know, secretly hiding there and making sure people don't, you know, go in that region, or else they will find out that Earth is actually a plate like this, and there are some secrets hidden by the government. Either they are hiding the aliens, or some secret technology which they don't want to share, or some other thing. I personally don't believe in flat Earth, but I cannot disprove it as well. I don't have any evidence to, you know, I have not gone to space to see whether Earth is flat or globe. So I can't definitely disprove it. I just have faith in the scientists and hope they are telling the truth. Sometimes it's difficult to trust them because they now don't tell everything. But I don't think they will hide about the shape of planet, you know. All the other planets and stars we have seen are like a globe. They are like a ball. So Earth is most probably a ball. But let me know if you believe in this theory And if you have any like where you know proof that Earth is actually flat rather than a globe, let me know. I know many people, you know, kind of make fun of flat earthers, you know, they call them stupid. But then again, we don't know enough about our surroundings. We don't know whether we are living in a real world or not. So, you know, let's not make fun of each other. Let's try to, you know, understand each other, you know, find out the secrets together, you know, uncover the world piece by piece. Arctic ice holes and the hollow earth theory. While flying over the eastern Beaufort Sea as part of NASA's Operation Iceberg, mission scientist John Sontag took some interesting photos there. So, NASA has released some enough photos of the Arctic region where from a distance it seems that the Arctic region has some kind of hole in it. There are many speculations on what it is. You know, I had seen some theories where they say it is actually a water region, and that region is actually due to the warm land surrounding that area. And I don't know the entire science behind it, but there are many like detailed theories on what those holes are. Some say it's water region, whereas some people say that I had seen one video where they said that this is actually a hurricane. You know, it was a hurricane forming in that area, that's why it looks like a hole. But you know, many people say that it is actually a hollow area, and there is a theory behind it, theory which is called the hollow earth theory. You know, this theory is actually originated from religious books. In many religious books, there people say that inside the earth there is hell. Those who do bad things are punished or sent inside the core of earth. When we talk about heaven and hell, heaven is in the space, whereas hell is in the inside of earth. So many religious books talk about inside of earth. There are many stories about it. Some say that inside the earth there is whole a world, different kind of world beneath it. Just like we have an outside earth, same way inside the earth there is a different kind of world where either aliens or different kind of creatures live over there. What we regard as aliens could be in a hollow earth people. They are also part of this planet, but they don't go above and we are not allowed to go inside. There are many much more details about it. If you want, I can make a separate video about hollow earth and its origin stories and more details about hollow earth. So let me know. Santa's house. Many people believe that Santa Claus actually lives in the North Pole region, in the Arctic region, with its wife Mrs. Santa Claus and his worker elves. The elves create the gifts all year round, and on Christmas Day, 25th December, Santa Claus goes in his sledge to give gifts to all the kids in the world. Again, we don't have any definite proof of it, but you never know. Maybe if we research in that area, maybe we can find Santa Claus inside the hollow earth. Maybe the hollow earth there, all the fairies and all the fantasy things are hiding inside hollow earth, and on the Christmas Day Santa Claus comes outside from the reindeer with the help of his reindeers and gives gifts. This is a joke, but many people, at least kids believe in it. Kids strongly believe there is a Santa Claus. So there is actually a Santa Claus. You know, there is a real life Santa Claus, and I had made a video about him last year. If you want to know more about the real life Santa Claus, please check out that video. He doesn't live in North Pole, unfortunately, but maybe the other Santa Claus may be living over there. Now we have to ask NASA and other space research organizations to locate Santa Claus. Maybe we'll find him. I haven't yet received any gifts. Hopefully this year I will get some gift from Santa Claus. My hair is kind of messy. I haven't combed my hair. I had washed my hair, that's why it's very not proper. And I keep the fan on to cancel the background noises, because there are lots of horn noises continuously moving, and those can be very annoying. I'm talking same thing and pop pop pop. I have to edit many a times. So this fan noise is better. I can cancel it in editing. By the way, Merry Christmas to everyone. I don't have a Christmas tree, but I have areca, and I thought of decorating it. It's very difficult to decorate it, and I barely managed to put this thing, but it's looking very pretty. By the way, so are you planning to celebrate Christmas? In this time it's very difficult to go out, do anything. But let's keep the Christmas spirit alive. We can enjoy our time inside our house, talk to each other on video or message, give each other gifts. And hope you have a joyous Christmas. And Happy New Year, there is still time. I will make another video where I will wish Happy New Year. Let me know if you want me to make a hollow earth theory. And if you have any other suggestions on other mystery places and other conspiracy theories and some fascinating theories, let me know. Or any other video suggestions you have, feel free to share it. And enjoy. Bye.